Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and last week we released a teaser video for one of the most requested features ever in Character Animator, body tracking. Thank you to everyone who saw the video and left comments. Some of you said you even cried or screamed when you saw the video, and I don't know if that was for the feature itself or my questionable dance moves, but we'll take it either way. We've been working on this feature for a very long time, and we felt like it was in a good enough state that we wanted to expand it to a slightly wider audience to get more testing and have more people trying it out before we decide to launch it into the full release of Character Animator. And so I'm extremely excited to announce that today, right now, you can download the beta version of Character Animator and try out body tracking for yourself. So in this tutorial, we're gonna walk through the basics of body tracking. We're gonna start with a simple torso up character and talk about arm tracking and all of that, and then move on into a full body character and what to expect there. As always, all of the example files I'm using today are free to download, and we've actually made a special website just for this feature. So if you go there, it's in the video description below. That has everything you need, all the example files, as well as information on how to join the beta for Character Animator if you haven't already. So if that sounds good to you, let's get started. So for quite a while, Character Animator has had the ability to track your facial features, your eyebrows, your pupils, the automatic lip sync as you're talking. But now with Body Tracker, you can start to move your hands around your arms, and Character Animator will look for those and do the tracking automatically. So it's automatically adding these tracking things to my hands, to my arms. It knows where my shoulders are, it knows where my torso is, where my hips are, and it's connecting that all into an experience that I can put together. So this is using Adobe Sensei technology, the same machine learning AI stuff that you may have seen in After Effects, Premiere Pro. We use it for the lip sync here in Character Animator, and it's great. I mean, previously in Character Animator, if you've had to try the hands before, you've had to drag them around with the mouse or use swap sets and triggers and have them kind of go up and down and do all that stuff. But now it's a lot easier and more accessible to do this. So I should say this is working with a standard webcam. I'm not using any, you know, depth sensing camera. I don't have to wear a skin tight suit with ping pong balls all over it. No one wants to see that. This is just any standard modern working webcam that normally works with Character Animator should work with body tracking. All right, so you may have noticed in the camera microphone panel up here, we've got three different icons. We have the webcam icon, turns the webcam on or off, the microphone icon for the automatic lip sync, and now this new one for body tracking. So this is turned on, but if I turn it off, you'll see the body tracking stops. And all it is now is the usual Character Animator, right? This is the normal face tracking and audio and all that stuff that you're used to. But if you want to add the body tracking, all you have to do is click that body tracker icon. And once that's on, now the body tracking will start. Now, to set up for body tracking, you are going to have to back up a little bit. Even for a torso up character, I really like to stand up. I think this is way easier to do than just sitting at your desk. You want to have enough room that you can see your hands go all the way out. If your hands get cut off or you're hitting a wall or something like that, you're just not gonna have the full mobility that you want for your character. So this might require moving some furniture back, move the bookshelves, move other things away to give yourself a little bit of extra space. And of course, as always, you wanna be well lit. The less crowded the background is, the better. I haven't noticed any major difference in wearing like different colored shirts or anything like that. But overall, as long as there's contrast between yourself and the background, things should work out pretty well. So calibrating your character with body tracking should just happen automatically, and things should just automatically start working. But sometimes, depending on where you're standing, you might see weird things like, you know, your head getting deflated into your character, or, you know, all over the place, something not feeling right. So what we have is, just like usual, this set rest pose right here. You would click that to calibrate, but it's going to do a countdown timer. And when it does that, what you want to do is make sure your whole body or whatever parts you want to track are in the frame, and set yourself in an A position. So your arms outstretched to the sides like this, like you're making the top of a letter A. So let's try this together. So I'm going to go to set rest pose, click that. It does a little countdown. I've got my arms all the way out in an A position. And that's going to recalibrate the character. Basically, this is now my zero position of the character. And everywhere I move from is based on this kind of being my central point. So if I take a step back, that's going to look a little bit weird. If I take a step forward, that's going to look a little strange. You basically want to stay in that same spot. And then that's going to be kind of your base of operations from there. Now, the body tracker is primarily controlled with the body behavior. So if you look in the right-hand column over here, we see all our different behaviors. You know, eye gaze controls the pupils, face controls the head, physics is all the hair bouncing and stuff like that. But body is the new one that we've added up here. Now, we have some really basic features for V1, and we would love to get your feedback. Is this enough, or are these working as you would expect, or do you need additional controls that would make things work better? That's the type of feedback we're really looking for to make this feature as good as we possibly can. But I'll walk through what we've got so far with the basics. So this first one, when tracking stops, hold in place. What does that mean? Well, sometimes with body tracking, you are potentially going to move out of the frame, right? So as I'm jumping around and dancing and doing all sorts of ridiculous things, there's a really good chance that at some point, my hand or whatever I'm trying to track is going to go out of the frame. And when it does that, what we're saying is, what should Character Animator do? So in this case, it's hold in place, meaning the wrist that's out of the screen right now, and I can even do more with my elbow. See how that's kind of just staying in one place? It's holding in the last known position it was at before it went off the screen. And then as soon as it gets the tracking data back in, it's going to remember and do it like that. Now, ideally, you have a setup where you're not going to need this that much, where, you know, if you've got enough space around and your arms and everything is working okay, this shouldn't play that big of a deal. But we know with body tracking, things get a little crazy sometimes, so we've added it in there. So you have two more options down here, and they're pretty similar. We've got return to rest and snap to rest. Basically, if the tracking gets lost, it's going to go, basically those things are going to go back to their rest position. So let's go to return to rest and just use this as the default. And so if I lose the tracking now and my arm starts to go out of the frame, look what happens. It's going to slowly go back to that A position that I started in. That was my rest position that I started in. That's the way that the artwork in the original Photoshop or Illustrator file that this character was made in was situated as. So as soon as it starts to lose tracking, it's going to go back to that position. Now you have control over how fast that is, right? So if I change this to 50 or something like that with the speed, and now I try it, it's going to be a lot snappier. It's going to kind of go down to that A position quicker and back and forth. And in animation, typically a little bit quicker is a little bit better, but play around with it. Personally, I found hold in place usually works 99% of the time, but play around with the settings and let us know what you think. So the final parameter you have control over here is tracked handles. And if you twirl this open, you're going to see all the different things that you can track with Body Tracker, and you can decide which ones you want to have on and which ones you want to have off. So you may be surprised to see that all the tracking that I've been doing so far is only with the wrist. So we have the wrists are being tracked, and the elbow bends and all of that stuff, and the shoulder and all that stuff is coming along for the ride, just the way that the character is set up. This character has limb IK system. She's got the head attached to the body. And so all I really have to do is track the wrists. Now I have the ability to track more if I want to. So if I go in here and say, okay, I also want to track the neck, the shoulder, the elbow. If you feel like that's going to give you more precision, go ahead and do that. Now there's no reason to tag this character's hips or anything like that because she doesn't even have that, but let's try this and see if we see any difference here. So honestly, I don't see that much difference when I change from the wrist to all these extra things. The one thing I notice is I get a little extra shoulder movement, so I can kind of do that back and forth and get a little dimensionality to the character. There's a little bit of motion there. But honestly, I think for a lot of characters, just tracking the wrists for a torso up character is probably enough. So play around with it and let us know what you think we should have on by default or what seems to work best for your types of characters. All right, so a few tips when dealing with the body tracker. Number one, know the limitations of your character, right? So this is a 3/4 character and she's kind of facing one side, right? So an arm motion like this is going to look pretty good. But if I go the other way, arm motions like this, that doesn't look as great. So play around with your character and kind of practice and know what their limitations are. So with this character, I realized I could do stuff like this. I can kind of scratch my head, back of my head, do a gesture like this. I can even pretend like I'm clapping, something like that. Just play around with it and kind of see what are your key poses and what are the limits of your character. The second thing, bigger gestures tend to work better. So when I'm making gestures, I'm not too subtle, right? I make these big grand gestures and track those and move those around as opposed to doing smaller gestures. The problem is right now we don't have any concept of foreshortening. So when I start to put my arms out like this, the character is gonna just freak out and not look really good, right? So That's another limitation. Ideally, in the future, we're going to have a solution for that. Maybe you have to draw some additional artwork of what this is going to look like, or we have some magic behind the scenes. I'm sure someone somewhere at Adobe has already figured this out, and it'll be in the product eventually. But what for now, basically try to avoid those kind of foreshortened moments when you do this sort of thing, and do these more grand, big gestures. And that tends to work a lot better with the current version. So recording a performance with the body tracker is easy. All you have to do is make sure that this red dot is on next to body tracker. Anything that you want to record needs to have a red dot next to it. And then as soon as you click the red record button, that's going to record any new data that's coming in. A note about doing performances. I think a lot of times, and this is true of the normal Character Animator app too, when people get it, they're moving all over the place and dancing and having a lot of fun with it. But for 2D animation, typically what looks better is actually what we call post-to-post style animation. So you'll notice in a lot of, if you watch just any cartoons you like, 2D cartoons, you'll notice a lot of times the characters will start in one pose and then they'll move to another pose and then they'll try something else as they're talking and then they'll make this gesture and maybe a slight adjustment to it and then things like that. That's a more traditional 2D look, and that's going to typically look a lot better to your viewers than if you're moving all over the place and trying to do this, you know, fancy, live one-to-one feeling. So just play around with it and see what looks best for you.
All right, so let's move over to rig mode and see how exactly you set up a character for body tracking. As usual, this is just a Photoshop file. You can import any Photoshop or Illustrator file and use Character Animator with it. So in this case, what I've done is first added the body behavior. So I go to my top level puppet up here, I click the plus button, and I go ahead and add body to it, and that's going to add it to my root level of behaviors. Now, typically, you're also going to want the limb IK behavior in that same spot. Limb IK is not required, but we highly recommend it for the best possible results with body tracking. So make sure those are two that you have at the root level. The second thing, we're looking for these tracked handles. And so you want to find whatever you're tracking, make sure you have that stuff tagged. And ideally for the arms, you're going to have, let's find an arm down here. You're going to have the wrist, the elbow, and the shoulder tagged. So here on the hand around here, I've got the wrist tagged. Here I have the elbow tagged. And then notice I don't have the origin of the arm here tagged. The shoulder instead should be tagged at the body level. If you have it tagged at the arm level, if this was instead tagged as a shoulder, the arm has a tendency to fly off of your character and you probably don't want that. So tag the arm, the wrist, the elbow on the arm, and then on your body group, wherever the arms are connected to, put new handles and add left shoulder and right shoulder there, and that's going to have the best results. Now, I've also noticed for the arms up here on attach style, hinge tends to work the best. Usually by default, when you attach things, they're set to the weld style, and that's going to get some pinching usually around where the arms are set. So I've found with body tracking, you feel like you get the most freedom when you've set these to the hinge attach style. So try that as well.
All right, so that arm tracking is great for most characters, but sometimes you're going to want to move everything, and that's where full body motion tracking comes into play. So check out on the right-hand side under the body behavior, everything is checked now. So this character has tags for his heels, his shoulders, his toes, everything. And because of that, not only is the hand tracking working and the head tracking, but also the legs as well. So if I were to do, you know, kind of a walk motion like this, the character is going to start doing it as well. If I were to, you know, start dancing, something like that, sashay back and forth. If I try to floss, he's going to try to do that. This character is not in the best position to do that, but you get the idea. And kind of move backwards a few steps, something like that. Move forward. So notice in the webcam, I am way far away from my camera. If you want to do full body motion tracking, you're going to want to have your entire self in the frame as best as possible. We've seen some pretty good results if your feet get cut off at the bottom, but if you can, if you have the ability to, try to get your whole body in the frame, and that's gonna give you the most options and the most room to kind of play around with things. The calibration process is exactly the same. We do have that countdown timer, so it's gonna give you 5 seconds to get in place, so let's do that. So, you know, if I'm in a different place, you'll notice the character might look a little bit different or not quite calibrated right. So if you need to calibrate, just go to here, set rest pose, run back, get in that A-frame position like this, and the character is going to reset and use that now as their starting point. And so everything, all the movements I'm making now are starting from that zero position that I calibrated to and that's how that's gonna work. So a couple of tips and considerations. Number one, again, know your character. This is going to look good for this character. Going back like this is not going to look great. Same with the way that the legs bend. Know how your character is situated and use that kind of as your guide of what type of actions and animations are going to look best for your character. Number two, things like crouching and jumping don't really look that great yet. So if I crouch, the character's kind of crumbling in on himself. If I jump up, there's a little bit, just too much latency that we can't quite track it perfectly. We'll work on that, but for now, that's a limitation. One thing you can play around with and let us know how it goes is if you turn up under the face behavior, if you turn head position strength up to something like 400, let's calibrate this again and see how this goes. So that's gonna give the head a lot more sway over how the character moves around. And then if you crouch, you'll notice it looks slightly better. At least the head is moving down a little bit, as opposed to kind of staying in place as it was before at the lower position setting. So play around with the settings. I'm sure there are some great settings for characters that will allow them to do crazier stuff. We've just kind of scratched the surface here and only, experimented with our own characters. So let us know what works best for you and how we can maybe tweak the default settings to make the most characters look great by default.
Rigging a full body character is pretty similar to how you would rig a character for limb IK or walking. So check out those tutorials if you want a little more information there on, okay, how do I tag the legs, add a knee and ankle and heel and all of that stuff, or the body, you want to have the hips and the shoulder, pretty much the same as you would expect for that. A few things that I played around with. Honestly, full body characters, I feel like I'm still experimenting and seeing what works the best. And the thing I'm playing around with this character, Baker, who's on the website so you can try him out, a few things are, number one, I've added a lot of independence. So I made the body independent, I made the head independent. These are things we normally tell you not to make independent, but it feels like it's working a lot better when I have those things move on their own. So I've toggled on the crown icon here for each of them. Another thing I played around with is setting the attach style to free. And that's gonna give a little more free movement to the character. If you find you're moving around and something in the character is pinching, like their waist or the middle of them or something like that, try selecting these main body parts and changing them to attach style free. I think I've done the same for frontal and the top level character. All of these are set to free. That's going to help it move a little freer and have a little bit of extra mobility to it. So the example puppets on the website are going to have a bunch of different ways that they're rigged. So try them out. And if you want to rig your own, use those as an example and a guide. And, you've got a working version here with all these example files. So test it out on your own characters and see what works best for you. So there it is, body tracking in Character Animator powered by Adobe Sensei. And this is the part where you come in. We would love to get your feedback. We know that this is in a very early initial state, and we would love to continue to push it as far as we can go and fix all the bugs we can and make the experience as seamless as possible before bringing it into the official full shipping release version. So it's really a matter of when, not if, that it's going to make it to the full version of Character Animator. And a lot of that is dependent on the feedback that you give us. So please go to that website we mentioned earlier, download the example characters, play around with them, try it on your own characters if you have any, and give us feedback in the beta forums. There's a link in there to give us your feedback. That's the best place to post things, post videos, post screenshots, post your puppets, anything you can. The more information, the better. And that's just going to help us make this product, this feature, as good as we possibly can. So thank you in advance for all of your help, and stay tuned, because body tracking isn't the only surprise we have in Character Animator. We've got a few things cooking that I think are going to be pretty exciting. So stay tuned to that. And as always, thank you so much for watching and have fun.